In this lecture, we are going to discuss epistasis. It is an interallelic gene interaction in which one gene masks expression of another gene. So there is a word mask, which is very important, or we can call it as the masking of gene. Here, one gene masks expression of another gene. So the whole concept of epistasis is based on the masking of gene. To understand this, let's draw a homologous chromosome. So it's a homologous chromosome and it has two locus, locus 1 and locus 2. On locus 1, there are two genes, capital A and small a. And on locus 2, again there are two genes, capital B and small b. Capital A is dominant over small a, and capital B is dominant over small b. Now suppose capital A is responsible for the red flower color. Capital A codes for red flower color, and capital B codes for, say, yellow flower color. I'm taking an example only to discuss this concept. So it's a hypothetical gene, capital A and capital B, and small a and small b. Okay, where capital A codes for red flower color and capital B codes for yellow flower color. Now, when capital A pairs with small a, it will code for red flower color, and when capital A pairs with small b, it will again code for red flower color. However, when capital A pairs with capital B, in epistasis, it has been found that it will also code for red flower color. If you see here, both A and B are dominant genes, where A codes for red flower and B codes for yellow flower. When both these dominant genes are combined together, only one gene is being expressed, that is A. And the expression of B has been masked by A. So such kind of gene is called epistatic gene. So we can call A as epistatic gene. And capital B as hypostatic gene. So this is the concept of epistasis, where one gene masks the expression of another gene. So in this example, A is masking the expression of B. Now, in epistasis, there are two conditions. One is dominant epistasis and the other is recessive epistasis. So here we see two conditions. First is dominant epistasis. It is found in summer squash fruit color. Example is summer squash fruit color. The scientific name of summer squash is cucurbita pepo. And the F2 ratio, which is found in epistasis, that is dominant epistasis, is 12:3:1 as against 9:3:1. Likewise, In recessive epistasis, it is found in coat color in mice. And color of bulbs in onion. And the F2 generation ratio, that is the phenotypic ratio in recessive epistasis, is 9:3:4 as against 9:3:3:1. So we will discuss separately this dominant epistasis and recessive epistasis separately, but first we will start with dominant epistasis.